After an absence of 20 years, the biggest selling recording star of them all, the comeback BIRDIE.
Thank you. Oh, no, no, we're not the lieutenants, Mr. Matobi. No, you see, this used to be our office, and we're looking for one of our clients who disappeared. Now, his last contact...
Mr. Matobi is not interested in detail.
Wrong! Details are exactly what I mean if I'm going to take this case.
What case?
Why, the missing party. You're looking for something. I take the case, I find the client, and hope he gets it that way. Now, you say, the clue is in this cabinet. Voila!
Oh, Rose! Look, Ming, one of the tales from Mama's matching muff that went with the coat. Oh, Rose, why did she leave us?
I take it, owner of Step Mama's daughter, her eternal reward.
Not quite, Mr. Matobi. Peterson's beloved mother disapproved of our marriage and strolled out of our lives some 20 years ago.
No problem! Tell you what, 250 cash, I'll find the old lady too.
That's a lovely offer, Mr. Matobi, and we will let you know next year or the year after that. Albert, dear, I beg you, please. Call the Granny people, tell them you can't find Conrad, and let's go home.
Wait a minute, did you say this guy's name is Conrad?
Oh, that's quite all right, Mr. Matobi. We decided to just forget about the whole thing.
Granny, Conrad, April 8th, 1960.
Wait a minute, let me see that. Why, it's a contract. Engagement between Mr. Conrad Birdie and the El Coyote Club, Bent River Junction, Arizona. I remember that now. That was a one-night stand after the week in Denver. Hey, Rose, let's go. We've got some packages. I'm going to start with Tucson first thing tomorrow morning.
Oh, yeah, I know we're in there. You know, we've got to back the
land. Hold it, the land. Oh, Rose, we took Conrad's last vote.
Get down!
20 happy years, playing softball, growing less.
And his health is suffering. It's indigestion.
Yeah, okay, I'll do the best I can. I can. Look at it. I'll see you around later.
Later, from here to eternity. You are me now. Spirit of my spirit. Flesh of my flesh.
Gotcha. Yeah.
I'm happy.
profits.
Albert, I know why you're doing all this publicity. The Telecapital Records of Conrad wants to find it. English 1 in the morning, show business in the afternoon.
No, you're wrong. I just wanted to publicity because you might turn up somebody who's seen him. Sing the song for your husband, Mr. McCovey. The youth of America is spontaneously gathering. Four, five, two, five, we'll go and
you off as a wild hoop chase a million miles from nowhere? Look at this place. There's not even a street lamp. For all we know, this bedroom conjunction might even be a ghost town. Rose, you know what I feel? Guilty.
That's all right, Albert. I understand.
No, you don't. These past 2,000 miles of that bus, you know what I kept saying to myself? I have taken advantage of Rose.
You have not taken advantage of me, Albert. I was perfectly comfortable then.
Well, you did lose the toss, Rose. Now, that doesn't change the fact that on occasion, and this is one of them, I have been less thoughtful than I might have been.
That's not true, Albert. You have always been extremely thoughtful.
Have I, Rose?
Yes. I appreciate
that. Nice to know what you're right. You know, 1,000 times a day I say to myself, is this good enough for my Rose? Will Rose be happy over that? I have a life proud of the best. But first and foremost, you know who I think of? My Rose. Why don't you rest a moment, dear? You get the rest of the luggage later. So we're in the desert. So the sun is hot. So the rain is so around for miles and miles. So what? Hey, things could be worse. And that ends the verse. The whole world is crazy. I think you love me. But baby, you can count on me. You need a strong captain when you're
power.
you a couple of questions.
We can understand that if it was for some 6'2" gorgeous Uncle Man. again, my deepest regrets that I haven't been able to be of help to you, and my sincere wishes that you would return again to our fair city under happier circumstances.
So thank you.
Thank you.
Very nice to see you.
What did you say?
Well, I just tended my sincere wishes.
I was heading for the station where the sun is coming. If it like a trailer took a dynamite, a little dose of shadow is in on your back. I'm a space serial on the stomach. Well, I thought it was an echo, but I heard myself say heck no. I'm a space serial on the stomach. In a world that's coming, it's safe.
Fit.
They never come back to the drag race.
Thank you. A couple little chicken scratchings.